Hi everyone. So we're going to talk about BLE transport for lip2p. So to give you a little bit of context, I work at Berti and we are creating a messaging app. So that's why we needed a BLE transport. So let's start with a quick overview. There is some spec comparison. So obviously, BLE is less consuming and have less bandwidth than Bluetooth Classic. One important thing is that you have optional device pairing. That means you don't need to go to your OS setting to pair your device. You can do everything to code. The protocol have an unlimited number of MAC connections. It's only dependent on the chip you use and the OS you use. And for the whole, we'll see in the next slide. So, difference between connection model. In Bluetooth Classic, you can only act as a master or a slave. If you are a master, you can have up to 7 slaves. In Bluetooth Low Energy, you can act as a master, as a slave, or both at the same time. So, obviously, it's a lot more peer-to-peer friendly. GRTT, all BLE applications are built on top of GRTT profile. You can see that as a kind of API endpoint. So let's take an example. If you have thermostat, it will advertise thermostat service with two characteristics. The first one is the current temperature, which is read-only. And the second one is the desired temperature, which is read and write, so you can set the temperature you want. So let's talk about the transport implementation. We are using the Golang version of lip2peer, and for now we have only two native drivers, one for Darwin, so iOS and macOS, and the other one for Android. So this is our stack. We implemented the common interfaces of GoLip2P2P. So we have a transport, a listener, and a capable con. This part will talk with the native driver, written in Objective-C and Java. This driver will talk with the low-level API of Android and Darwin. And this part will finally advertise a Berti service with three characteristics. So the two first ones are read-only, one for the multi-address, and the other one for the peer ID. And the third one is write-only, and it's a writer. It will act as unilateral socket, kind of. So I will skip that one. Yeah, so when you found another peer, you can start the uncheck, and you have two parts in your application, the GRTT master and the GRTT slave. So as you can see, lip2p will call the BLE master of your BLE application. It will read the multi-address and the peer ID characteristic of your BLE slave of your peer. Then the driver will lock until your peer has read your own characteristic. Then both devices can agree on the biggest common MTU. It will have a huge impact on your performance. And on the lip2p level, both peers will add each other in their respective peer store. So it's also a peer discovery service. And they will auto-connect accept. Then that's it. The connection is established. So as you can see, lip2p will, lip2p will call conwrite, it will talk with GRTT master that will write on the writer of the BLE slave of your peer, and this will trigger the connection read, and vice versa. Some final note, you can't rely on MAC address with BLE because they are rotating quite frequently. Reliability depends a lot on the chip you use. It's particularly noticeable on Android. It's slow. You can't send video or big pictures with BLE. A possible improvement is to use L2CAP channel. We want to implement a driver for Linux and Windows. Our implementation will be open source soon. In the meantime, if you have any question, you can reach out ID, which is me, or Esfromont, which is my teammate, on both GitHub and the Discord. And we will have a sci-fi fair stand with my team. We wear the Bertie t-shirt, so you can come say hello. Thanks for listening.